A third Filipino is confirmed killed in last weekend's Hamas attack on Israel. Dozens of Filipinos are now asking to be repatriated from Gaza as Israel orders a mass evacuation ahead of an expected ground assault. Pia Gutierrez has tonight's top story.
A third Filipino fatality in the Israel-Hamas war has been confirmed. The victim, identified as Loretta Alacre, was supposed to return to the country this December to celebrate her 50th birthday. Loretta has been a caregiver in Israel for 15 years, a lone breadwinner supporting her 8 siblings.
Sila lang ang po nagbawa sa amin magkakapatid. Dinamay nila yung walang ka, alam-alam. Hindi naman kasama yung mga Pilipino.
Kasi nagbibigay din sa akin ng allowance ko. Yung mga pinsan ko ngayon, yung dalawang nag-aaral ng college, siya din po nagpaparal. Yun na po, baka puminto dahil sa nangyari sa kanya.
The Philippine government vows full support to Filipinos affected by the conflict.
Sa nasawi, kung yan ay active na OWA member, 220,000 kagad yung bibigay natin. Ito yung mga anak, bigyan natin ng educational support. Magmula ngayon hanggang sa makagraduate yan, basta yung panganay niya. Ngayon, kung kaya kami lagi in close coordination with the DMW, para yung hindi naman namin kaya, mabilis na matutugunan.
The Overseas Workers Welfare Administration is calling on families of missing Filipinos to reach out to government so they can be given the necessary assistance. 3 Filipinos remain unaccounted for. The Department of Foreign Affairs says that preparations are in place to evacuate Filipino nationals in Gaza once Israel opens humanitarian corridors to allow civilians to leave the war-torn city. So far, 92 of the 131 Filipinos there have already requested government for repatriation. Almost all of them are spouses or children of Palestinian nationals.
We are getting ready. Our embassy in Cairo is sending a team to the border. And we are providing them funding to be able to rent the necessary transportation to bring them from the border to Cairo and to fly them to the Philippines. You took 92.
President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. in a meeting in Malacanang ordered agencies to prioritize the evacuation of Filipinos affected by hostilities. The DFA says aside from those in Gaza, at least 22 Filipinos in Israel have called on government to send them back home, with the first batch poised to leave the country by Monday.
Once they arrive, they'll be given the proper assistance, the usual reintegration and other assistance packages provided by the DMW and OWA.
For Defense Secretary Gilbert Chodoro, he says the Philippine government should be ready for what he calls a copycat effect of the Hamas attacks to other groups.
Disruptors, let's call that, or extremists. I mean, it always happens. So I'm not confining it to any particular group or any particular way of going forward. As much as possible, pinagre-ready natin.
The National Security Council says it will push for the designation of Hamas as a terrorist group in solidarity with the people of Israel. In a statement Friday, National Security Advisor Eduardo Año condemned the attacks on Israel as deadly and barbaric.